Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind for the Commodore Amiga Personal Computer System. I am Amethyst Lodotari. I just fought a bunch of vampires for about an hour last episode, and we have walked one step after that. I'm not sure where this goes, or we haven't been there before. Before I do anything, though, let's rest. Okay, good. Yeah, some of us are messed up. Okay. Pardon me. So the other thing that I'm trying to figure out is Twin Snake is completely out of ammo. So I wanted to give some of, I think, Runeclaw's ammo. So he's got 20. He was almost out on the shotgun. By the way, if anyone was, like, paying attention to all this stuff at the end of last episode, or keeping track or whatever, I had to play the battle. I had to fight the battle all over again because I didn't save correctly. You have to make sure to save, you know, normally in a file name, and then you have to press F10 to exit. If you don't press F10, your save that you just save with the file name doesn't take. If you press F10 but don't save, you don't have a save. So that's what I did last time. I pressed F10 but then forgot to save. So I had to fight that all over again. It was alright. Practice, maybe. So what I was trying to figure out how to do is to split this. This is an ammo supply of 20. So I wanted to take 10, keep that for Runeclaw, and then take the other 10, give it to Twin Snake, but I couldn't figure out how to do it. I don't know if there is a way to do it. I was trying all, you know, shift, click, alt, click, control, click, and just generally messing around to see if I could split up this ammo, and I can't. So if there's a way to do it, I haven't figured it out. So in any case, Twin Snake at the moment is going to become a melee combatant, unless we find some more ammo for his Rex regular carbine. So, we can analyze this. Now, I think the way we do that. SE, not ZE. Okay, so average wounding of 14. Range is obviously 2, you're gonna be right up on somebody. Alright. Physical attack. I'm gonna put just 1425 on it. So, because I know we have other things. I don't know if he can use the shuriken? It's a good question. I don't know who has a shuriken. Hold on 1 second. I just gotta look at something. Alright. Shuriken! You do not have. Not everyone can use that, obviously. Let's see. Oh. I gotta put this back. Okay. him. See, he's got extra. He's got throwing stars here. Just didn't realize that. And he's got some there, so... Mediator, Psionic, Anchorite, and Assassin. I don't even remember what he is. Did I write this stuff down? Anywhere? At some point I did, but I might have tossed it. But I really should have held on to that stuff. Because I don't remember what kind of character Twin Snake is. Oh, if I can see that. But, I mean, that's obviously a range. The wounding is 14, which is the same. Dexterity needs to be 30. So I have to check that out. Range attack is 55 instead of the dagger's 25. End of information. Oh, dexterity is way higher than 30. So from, at least as far as that is good. Ah, he's a mercenary. I don't think that was one of the ones listed. Sorry guys, I know it looks like I'm going in circles, but at least now I know he's a mercenary. I don't think that's one of the characters listed. Classes listed, rather. Nope. No mercenary there. So he cannot use throwing stars, aka shuriken, what have you. You wouldn't call him Chinese throwing stars. There's no China in this world. I don't know what region throwing stars we'd have in this world, but... Alright. Okay, so I'm sure he can't use this stuff either. What about the tiger claws? Those look pretty cool, huh? Just trying to figure out what to give Twin Snake or just have him use the dagger. He can't use that either. Nope. Okay. Yeah, so nothing there. Got a crossbow with 6 ammo. That could even be just a temporary fix, because we only have six ammo for it. Average wounding is 18, that's good. Perception needs to be 30. Range attack, 30%, okay. I might just give him that. I hate how you can't switch weapons in battle like that. I mean, let us do it. I mean, if it takes a full round, fine. You know, just let us do it. So he can use this. So now he's got that. Can he put this in this hand? He can. Alright. This way he runs out of this, because only has six ammo. He'll switch to the bayonet. It's not a two-hander. It's not a Duma. So we've got... Killdozer has this one with 13 ammo. Scorpion gun. Oh, he also has this crossbow with 5 ammo. Can we give this to Twin Snake as well? We'll just switch to the other crossbow at some point. Okay. That's promising. So we got that one with 5 ammo and this one with 6 ammo. I don't think they do a lot of damage, but what are you gonna do? Here he only has 2 ammo, so... But he has this... Hold on. Is he not... like a ninja cat? Let me just double... Pretty sure he can use all that stuff. Personal information. He's a psionic. Alright, so... Let's see if psionics can use this. They can. Dexterity needs to be 30. Takes a while to flip through all this stuff. Alright. Is dexterity 30? Yes. Alright, so I'm gonna give him these. Okay, good. So when he runs out, he'll be using the throwing stars. He's got a good amount of ammo, Killdozer. Epsilon is a pretty good amount. Now Twin Snake has these two crossbows. Runeclaw has this and the throwing stars. Varanus has this and throwing stars. And Advent. Yeah, he's almost out as well. Let's see if anyone else has something for him. So he's a mediator, for sure. Double check. Oh no, he's an anchorite, sorry. I'm unfamiliar with these terms. Anchorite. Let's see. Can you use this anchorite? Yes, you can. Okay, good. You have not enough dexterity to operate that item. Oh. How much does it require? I didn't even wasn't even paying attention to that. I guess the one time I don't notice everything. Well, he has really bad dexterity. Dexterity of 30. Oh, what's his dexterity? See. Twenty-six, so close, right? Alright, let's see if we can find something that doesn't require that much dexterity. How about this? The nunchuck. I just have to give him the dagger. Let's see. Oh, anchorite cannot use. And this requires dexterity of 40 as well, so he doubly can't use this. He does not have the dexterous properties. I have a feeling he can't even use that. That's all we can give him. Alright. Oops. Anchorite's the only one he can't use. How sad. Okay. So I wonder if I should give him the other crossbow. But who knows if we can use that. Anchorite can use it. Perception needs to be 30. perception. 56. Okay. Let's give him that. Okay. So if we go to attack with arranged, how does it choose which one? Or is it going to prompt us? That's a good question. But I'm just putting them all in their slots because I can't switch it during battle. Very limiting. Okay. So step one of saving correctly is this. I spent a lot of time just doing that. Right. We went through. Okay, I know where we are. Whoop! Whoa! What's that? After stepping out from the teleporter beam, you feel the same thrilling presence that you've already felt near the center of the turbulence. And then the darkness itself begins to congeal into a wicked shape. Panic breaks out among the people in the hall as the creature, described only by the greatest explorers of alien universes, takes its final form. They described it. You have never imagined, even in your wildest dreams, that the unborn in its present form is powerful enough to summon a demon from the plane of distortion. But actually, that's what happened. Oh, brother. A lot of battles now. Okay. I would be sorely remiss if I didn't try to communicate with this thing. It's a weird idea to talk to creatures like this one. Yeah, it's true. You might have an interesting story to tell. Alright then. Can I analyze the creature there? No item, no. That's for items, okay. Alright. Battle! Okay, so that's Epsilon. He needs to take cover, because he can get one-shotted. Luckily, he is the quickest among us. Let's see if we can make him even quicker. We can. I'm gonna have him hide a little around here as well. Oh, look at that thing. The demon performs preparations, blah blah blah. So he's most likely going to attack whoever's sitting there. Now this screams boss battle all over. Shouldn't have left them out like that. Killdozer. That's not really good cover, is it? that speed up. Now, what I found out also is that if you prepare a spell and then cancel it out, it still takes away your mana, magic points, what have you. Oh, that thing's right there. Hopefully you can't target him. I think you need a full body. Yeah, I think this half stuff is no good. But the demon. Yeah, cheesy. Okay. Yeah, he's not directly in line of sight. So we have to abort that out. Missed. We're running out of ammo. We can't be missing like this. Okay, so he's not going to be able to target anything. I want this thing to come to us as much as possible. He canceled his attack. Can't do it. But in case the demons decide to swing over and come up here, life force drain. Take that. I'm not going to be able to get... You're in my way. I'm not going to be able to squeeze through there. Coming around with these guys. Kill it! Crossbow missed. More speed. What's his speed at now? F- 433. Curious about something, too. He is the fastest, and Killdozer has the only medkit. We need more of those. Can I analyze this stuff during combat? Because I was wondering if he could be our medic. So I can't give it to him now. I have to wait till after the battle. All classes. Alright. So we want to give that to Epsilon because he is the most vulnerable character out of all of us. But he is the fastest. So out of anyone able to run over and bandage someone up, it would be him. I'll have to keep that in mind. Oh, what's that? A hypnotic suggestion, and then Killdozer with deadly astral energies? Okay. How is he doing? Because that would normally kill people. It would kill some people in one shot. Affects his vitality and stamina, possibly? Strength, maybe a bit also. Speed? Oh, speed went up, so the total goes up and you don't get the benefit of the speed until you rest. I think that's the way it works. Because he's going to be still at 103, and then once we rest, he'll be at 113. But I think that took away his stamina and possibly vitality as well. And maybe a bit of strength. So it took away like 42 stamina. Well, that would kill some people right off, maybe. Oh, they got pretty decent stamina. Okay. Like Varanus. Not sure why he dies so easily. Maybe he won't now. I don't know. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. So he's partially obscured by the wall. Okay. Oh, he's got a cone. It's gonna hit him. He can't do it. He can't do that. He might have been able to attack. Not directly. Just an area of effect, but he would have hit whoever that is. I think that's Varanus. The demon advances. I don't think he has line of sight either. I can't do that. So in case it comes back around this way, I'll be ready. Pretty sure I'm not gonna be able to target him. Nope. Speed. Now he could target him, so he should be able to. No, all right. Yes! Now we can, well, two of us can target you anyway. I'm pretty sure he can't. Thing is, if I put anyone in his line of sight, he can also attack us. Cannot do. Get that speed in. Now you should be able to hit him. Damn, missed. How dare you miss? I flog you 20 times. Hit and run tactics, really. Let's do the defense. Hypnotic suggestion. Don't. Okay, good. Who got hit? I'm not even sure who that was. He's attacking vitality and stamina. Uranus really can't get hit by that thing. That's not gonna work. Oop. It's like we're running around the table. You know those movies where someone's chasing someone and they're running around a table? Trying to remember. I'm sure one of the Friday the 13th was like that. Jason's trying to get to him. Or her. Probably a her. And you can tell, you can only tell he gets mad because he starts breathing really heavy, like, my god, I'm gonna kill you. Yes, no way that's gonna work. Oops. It says it slightly bent its head. What was that, Twin Snake? Twin Snake. I was going on with Twin Snake. He was probably the one hit before as well. Okay, so his stamina is affected. Oh, he could take a few hits, unless he's just been lucky, unless it's a roll for damage, and that was just a low damage roll. We can't target that, I know. We gotta make it jump, step out. And then begin its attack, and then we attack, and then run out of the line of sight before it gets to use its attack. That's my strategy. They're the only one I have at this point. Varanus, he's the one who cannot be hit by this thing. So I am gonna keep him right there. Weapon empty. Alright, but we have these. Is that also a range attack? You're standing too far from that character. I am that character! So, is that a weapon is empty. Can I switch them? Because I'm holding it. You have not enough action time. Alright, so I guess I could switch them. Well, I'll defend this time just in case. I'll have to remember to do that next time. Who is this? Okay. And a snake. Let's see if we can do this. If I go like this. Unaffected. See, now that he's out of the line of sight, I have to sneeze. Or it's gonna go away, the one. Hold on a second, guys. It wouldn't happen. The sneeze didn't happen. I hate that. Yeah, I'm saying this guy might step over to attack these guys now. I don't know. Hold on a second. Ugh, I hate that. Alright. Oh boy, preparing for a physical attack. Now the good thing about that is I think we can just step out of range of its physical attack, still be near it, and it can't attack because it needs to switch weapons then, even if it's a natural weapon. But Varanus isn't gonna, I mean, not Varanus. Advan isn't gonna make it to attack it this round. He will, though. Leave the way for Twin Snake to get out of dodge. Yeah, we can't be doing that. He can attack range. Whoops. He can't get between them. Huh. His weapon's empty. Oh yeah. I don't know how to... Oh, I forgot to do it. Varanus, I gotta switch his to his other hand. Alright. Hopefully I remember next time, that's all I can say. Defend, I guess. Now he lost his turn that he has to prepare for a range attack. Gonna work, is it? This is not an area weapon, yeah. Trying to get that speed, there we go. His weapon's empty. Reload this. Not of action time. Alright. I gotta have them both do it now. Get their weapons sorted. So, Sam defend. And who's this? Okay. Alright, Varanus. Well, there is no more place left for that item. Well, how do I actually use it? Do I have to put that in there? Do I have to switch it to the right hand? Are we all righties here? I missed the message if saying this is things preparing for an attack or something. This is Epsilon. We're basically gonna have him run run around in circles, trying to get his speed up even more. You gotta give him that med kit. I guess the faster they get, the quicker they, you know, because the faster you go, the more you can move, and the more you can move, your speed goes up 575. Wow. Compare that to Killdozer with 124. And Advent's really slow at 52. Right. We need to get these guys up there. Okay, Demon preparing for a range attack. This is not gonna work. I fixed him up, right? Oh, he's got nothing. Oh, wait. Hey, there are no items! Well, he's... I'm not sure what I'm doing. Alright. I thought... I don't know. It was Runeclaw I gave the shuriken to? It's not even his turn and I can load this stuff. Alright. Some of these people I just hold in reserve because they just... they can die so easily. Nope. I had a feeling that was gonna work. Even this won't work. I guess he's targeting wherever that is. It might be Twin Snake. I messed that up. I guess he's using an area weapon against him. So he's already out of this crossbow. Not enough action time. Okay. Then he will defend for this round. Preparing for a physical attack. Oh, his weapon's empty. Hold on. Not enough action time. Alright, so he can move that into the backpack, but he can't move that over yet. Oh, he's preparing for physical. And that's not gonna work. And this won't work. Keep missing. No more missing. Against the law. This thing was preparing for a physical attack, so I think we're safe this round. I'll just now he's preparing for range. So now we gotta scurry. Who's this? Empty crossbow. Wow. All right. Defend. Just checking. Oh yeah, he's good. I'm just gonna move him out of the way. Some people are going to be running over here. So I guess it's bleeding wounds stopped happening, because we did hit it once, and it's supposed to bleed out every round, and we stopped hitting it, and it stopped bleeding out, so. Well. Whoops. Slightly bows its head. Advent? Alright, I didn't like that very much. I was afraid he was gonna die. And then we're all over. Advent! Okay. Maybe because we've leveled up in the next battle. I haven't seen any one-shot kills like with the vampires. Let's see if we can do this. Like that. I know. Okay. Maybe I could get it in like an area effect. Yeah, he was doing physical attack. We can't have him doing that. Man. He can't move fast enough. That's his problem. So maybe if we move, if the thing is ready for a range attack, we won't get right in front of it. I mean, we'd probably still range attack whoever he can and just ignore whoever's in front of him. But if we make it so it's just one character in range, he'll lose his turn. I'll have to spend a round switching to, you know, physical or melee. Anyone else needs to switch ammo over? Okay, he's good. Good. I thought we had someone else we needed to switch, and I completely forgot. He's got the bayonet. That's Twin Snake, okay. He's good there. There. Alright. Advent. Well, I'm just trying to get him out of the way right now. Just building up speed here. Man, it really puts me on edge. Okay, his stamina is 77 out of 123. Apparently, we can take some hits from this thing. I mean, I thought this would be even more dangerous than the vampires, because there's only one of them. I think it's like boss battle or mini boss battle. Who's that? Okay. Who is this? That's, I think that's Twin Snake. Well, let's move him. It is, okay. So Advent can get out of the way, maybe. Alright, so as soon as this demon shows up, well, he's probably just going to wait at the corner. But we're going to try to drag him out so that all of us can fire on him. At least most of us. Let's see. I probably don't have time to do this. Like, enough rounds. I can't change weapons. It's already in my hand. While you're attacking. Oh. So I have to cancel our attack and then do it. Otherwise, I think he's just punching him. Yeah. Or punching it. Okay. Not doing anything yet. Alright. Will it let me do this now? Because I'm still attacking, right? I think it would not let me. Yeah. Alright, well, some of us can open fire on this thing. He attacked with nothing, that's right. He's the one I wanted to switch over the... Well, let's move him a little away. Wait. And I'm not gonna be able to... Well, we're not attacking. So maybe we can do this. Nope, not enough action time. So I will have him... defend. Missing. Up. They're just wasting ammo. We did hit it once, right? Alright, so now's where we scurry for cover. Preparing for a range attack, which means Twin Snake will be safe for a moment. Because he cannot hit me with a range attack unless the rules are different for the monsters. Preparing a physical attack. Trying to get this speed up. I'm afraid if I switch it now, he's not going to have enough movement points to get out of the way of this thing. Is that a harm's way now? I might have been able to move one less than I did, but... enough action time. Okay. Well, he'll just hang out here. Yeah. Hit him. Or not. Uh-oh. Epsilon? Salons are right. This is... oh. Stamina and vitality. Okay. Look how much speed he gained. Pretty sure we don't lose speed, so he just... almost doubled his speed. Insane. Ah! Nice going, Epsilon. Sweet. And he got a little bonus for that, too. Let's get him out of harm's way. As much as possible, anyway. He's not going to be able to make it through them. Can he stay in here? That's probably alright. Demon raises what? So if he heads over to Killdozer, he can get bandaged up. Well, he can attack him and run. Awesome. Everyone needs a medical kit. How's his stats? Stamina? Alright. Strength is really low, so hopefully it doesn't affect strength. I'm gonna try some spells on him because we don't seem to be hitting him very often. Maybe spells are the way to go with a creature like this. Oh, or not. So Killdozer is here. His friend needs to be bandaged up, but we got people in the way. Advent got two things? I only saw one message, but I heard it go off twice. Alright, well. Not gonna be able to hit him like that. Oh! I was wrong! Varanus can't do that. No. I think that's Killdozer. Awesome. Yay. I just gotta use up his points. Some more speed for the road here. The demon has been destroyed, and there's another huge episode. Alright. And before anything else happens, let's rest. Alright, nothing's coming after us. Okay, cool. And we save. Now I will hit F10. Right after I sign off. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Another huge episode. But I don't like to, you know, chop the battles in half. Just awkward, right? Anyway, so I'm going to call this an episode here, obviously. And thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.